Aimee, you know now Senator Butler. You also know Congresswoman Barbara Lee. I just want to start by getting your reaction. Did Governor Newsom make the right decision here?
We had been advocating since 2021 for Governor Newsom to appoint a Black woman, and we had not let up on or allowed him to forget that promise. And so first and foremost, both of the leaders, both Senator Butler and Congresswoman Lee, both are excellent leaders. I'm very pleased there's been an appointment. I'm very pleased Black women who are so important in American politics now have representation. And I'm really pleased that California now has a fully functioning senator in place. So I think all in all, it's such a positive move. It's such an indication of the growing political power of women of color. And especially because the governor really walked back the restriction on, you know, he just wanted a caretaker role. He said now he's not going to put those kind of expectations on an appointee. And we were very pleased that he backed off of that so that Black women and the senator and any candidates can actually fully run to the extent that they can appeal to the voters.
You know now Senator Butler, and for folks at home who don't, because she is not a household name, let's say, in the public space, did a lot of work behind the scenes leading Emily's List, also the leader of SEIU. What do you want folks to know about her?
Laphonza Butler, Senator Butler, is an insider. She knows how to appeal to and organize voters to win. She has a long history advocating from a labor leader perspective for working people, but she also embraces a lot of issues that Californians embrace in terms of not only economic equality, but LGBT issues. And most recently, I worked with her supporting women and a lot of women of color who are running for office both in California and nationally. We both backed Kamala Harris, Senator Kamala Harris, who obviously became our vice president. And so she had operated behind the scenes. She's more well known in Southern California, although those of us in Northern California hold a lion's share of influence in terms of vote for the primary. What they need to know is that Senator Butler, from my perspective, is one of us, that she's worked for our issues and she believes in opening up the doors of government. I think they can count on her to work with Chuck Schumer and the rest of her Senate colleagues to get things done, to work on keeping the government open, to secure votes, to start addressing some of the issues that Democrats have wanted to move forward, even in the face of what's going on in the House. So I think they should feel pretty good about the fact that we have a leader who's stepping into that role and who has the relationships that we need to get things done. I think longer term, I'm very, very interested and excited about partnering with Senator Butler. And at the same time, I'm going to be continuing to support the candidacy of Congresswoman Barbara Lee for Senate, a campaign that has already been well underway with quite a bit of infrastructure there.
So if Senator Butler decides to run, what is your decision going to be then? Will you stay with your support behind Barbara Lee?
It's interesting because, you know, look, I'm a Black woman who's worked with Black women throughout California and our allies advocating for this seat to be occupied by a Black woman, not just any Black woman, but a progressive, really strong leader. And I think Barbara Lee, in her campaign, really was, she was ready to go on day one. She would have been a natural choice for Newsom. And there were a lot of things behind the scenes that led to the situation that we have now. But one thing that people need to understand is that Black women are unified. Right now, they're unified behind the candidacy of Barbara Lee. And there's a lot of questions about what will happen in the special election, in the primary, all those elections next year. But right now, with the pieces that we have on the board, Barbara Lee has inspired not only the endorsement of key leaders in California and our revolution, which knows how to move votes statewide. And remember, Bernie Sanders won California a few years back, and that's the same infrastructure. She also has the support of the Congressional Black Caucus, which is a national power block in terms of funding and visibility and support. So right now, Barbara Lee is the only Black woman in the race. She has my support. Senator Butler has a decision to make, and she has until the 7th of December to make that decision, whether she's going to jump into the primary or not, whether she's going to run and that would change the dynamic. And I think Black women have done a really, really good job of staying unified, not just for Black women, but for women and women of color who have been pushing for representation throughout our state. So the short answer is right now, we're united behind Barbara Lee. And as things evolve, we will absolutely be united in whatever the decision is, because we want to make sure that we have representation in that California Senate seat, no matter what happens.
You mentioned a lot of variables up in the air, and one of those variables is Senator Butler's decision that we're still awaiting right now. I want to get your reaction to a piece in the San Francisco Chronicle written by our friend Joe Garofoli. I know you participated in that piece. There's a quote from you, but I want to get you to react to his prediction. He says, when the dust settles from this appointment, look for Butler to say that she is not running for a full term. Then it will be her decision, not Newsom's restriction. So would it a scenario for you to be the best possible one is Senator Butler does not run, makes the decision as Joe is predicting, and he's been around for a long time and has been covering this stuff for a long time, and then comes out and endorses Barbara Lee and brings, you know, the power of her advocacy space.
That would be like the next level in Black women not only having a seat at the table, but using their political power to ensure that the person that comes after them has the support to govern long term. That would be a dream scenario. As you know, politics isn't always that smooth and neat. But what we can say is that, I could see very easily Senator Butler deciding that this was going to be an interim appointment. As somebody who has a long history as a political insider and someone who operates both on the national level and statewide and understands the mechanisms of politics, for many of us, we were surprised by the appointment and know that how savvy she is in terms of how political power moves. So I wouldn't be surprised if that prediction by Joe Garofoli is actually correct.
And also, too, I mean, you know this, you recruit women of color as part of the organization that you founded to run for office. And it's comes down to money and name ID, and, you know, as you highlighted here too, Laphonza Butler is an unknown. She is an insider, but all of these prominent Democrats running in this race right now, with Adam Schiff, of course, he's got, what, $32+ million in the bank, Congresswoman Katie Porter and Congresswoman Barbara Lee, they're struggling with name ID, and even voters, polling showing that voters are undecided and not even really knowing that there's a Senate election taking place right now. I mean, that's a struggle.
It's a real struggle. It's expensive to run statewide, really any state, but California in particular. Money is a big determinant how, you know, how far they can reach on TV and social media to tell their story. What we do know is when we tell the story of Congresswoman Barbara Lee for people who are younger, let's say under 30, they may not have understood she's been how long she's been working for abortion rights and working people's rights and on behalf of the disenfranchised and the dispossessed. I mean, they may not know that, but when they hear that, they are supportive. We found a similar dynamic with Senator Butler, where when people knew her long advocacy and on behalf of working people at SEIU, the union, on behalf of women's leadership, they're impressed. So, but I think the money issue, we really have to look at California and how politics runs. Money is not the last word. Moving votes is. So, you know, when we look at the primary has obviously three major candidates, and the top two are going to have to garner about 1.5 million votes. In a state as large as ours, that isn't that many votes. So the actual practical dynamic is, whoever has the ground game to get inspired voters to turn in those ballots, and because we all have these mail at home, you know, ballots in hand, that's a whole month to do that. It isn't just ads on TV that'll determine that. It's actually boots on the ground. So you have to look at that as an important factor when determining who's, you know, likely to be able to garner that many votes and be competitive. And it's not just a matter of money. It's a matter of the whole, you know, activating people who, organizations, these are nonprofits and other kinds of community groups who have a long history and experience talking to communities, particularly communities of color, and activating their vote. I think that's going to be the X factor in this upcoming primary.
Karen Bass and the Rick Caruso race confirm everything that you just laid out there. She was up against a giant in terms of money, but the grassroots ground game, and she prevailed. Aimee Allison, we appreciate your time here on Inside California Politics.
Thanks so much for having me.